श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। तपो विद्या विरक्त्यादि सद्गुणौघाकरानहं वादिराज गुरुन् वंदे हयग्रीव दयाश्रयान्। कामधेनु यथा पूर्वं सर्वाभीष्टफलप्रदा तथा कलौ वादिराजः श्रीपादोभीष्टदस्सतां विद्यापीठ विधातारं विद्यावारिधि चंदिरं विद्यार्थिवत्सलं वंदे महामहिम सद्गुरुं। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। वादिराज तीर्थ स्वामी जी, वी वुडेंट फाइंड इवन अ सिंगल पर्सन बिलोंगिंग टू एस्पेशली आर मध्वा कम्युनिटी नॉट फेमिलियर विद द नेम ऑफ द सेंट वादिराजरु। नॉट जस्ट आर मध्वास, मेनी पीपल एस्पेशली गोल्ड स्मिथ्स, बिलियनर्स ऑफ दोज टाइम्स, पीपल ऑफ बैकवर्ड क्लासेस टू, ऑल ऑफ देम वर्शिप वादिराजरु एज देयर डाइटी। सच वॉज द ग्रेटनेस ऑफ वादिराज तीर्थ स्वामी जी। वादिराज तीर्थ लिव्ड अ वेरी लॉन्ग एंड ग्लोरियस लाइफ ऑफ 120 लॉन्ग ईयर्स कंप्लीटली। ही इज कंसिडर्ड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सेंट्स इन द द्वैत वेदांत ट्रेडिशन। इट इज बिलीव दैट ही लिव्ड ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड ऑफ 1400 to 1600 AD। यूजुअली वेन एवर वी कम अक्रॉस और रीड अबाउट द बायोग्राफीज ऑफ फेमस कैरेक्टर्स, बी इट सेंट्स, पोएट्स, हूएवर, every instant in their life seems to be miraculously planned. The same happens in the life of Vadirajaru. Vadirajaru's birth happened quite interestingly. A couple, Ramabhatta and Gauri Devi, they had no issues since very long time, even after marriage. When once Vagishtirtha Swamiji visited their village Huvinakere, the couple begged the saint to bless them with a child. Then Vagishtirtha Swamiji blessed them on one condition, that the child to be given to the mutt once born. The couple at once dumbstruck didn't know what to do. The couple agreed on a condition that they shall hand over the child to the mutt only if the child is born inside outside the house. The couple conditioned this thinking that the child will obviously be born in the house. As usual, 9 months passed by, 9 months completed. On a Sadhani Dwarshi day, Gauri Devi was performing her Tulsi Puja and yet she had to take her meals to complete her Parani. Suddenly, few cows entered the paddy fields and started eating the crops and destroying them. She chased the cows and in that process, she moved quite away from the house, forgetting about the agreement. Suddenly, her labor pain started and she delivered the child in the paddy fields itself. Immediately, Vagishtirtharu came to know about the birth of the child and sent a golden plate from the mutt so that the baby should be put in the plate and brought to the mutt, and baby never touches the ground until it reached the mutt. The baby was fed with the milk only which was done Abhisheka to the Lord and fed with the food which was done Naivedya to the Lord. The child was named as Bhuvaraha. We find the same situation, same instance even happening when we learn about the history of Raghutama Tirtha Swamiji, the one of the great pontiffs of Uttaradi Math Parampara. Bhuvaraha was growing like a Purnima moon. His glory was increasing day by day. Bhuvaraha learnt all the skills in childhood itself. The child's interest in the matha increased day by day. The parents reluctantly sent him daily to the mat to learn. He wouldn't even return few days. Once, Vagishtirtha Swamiji brought few fruits, books, clothes and few necessities and called all his disciples to take whatever they wanted. Everyone took whatever they desired, but Bhuvaraha had no interest in all of them. He just simply kept quiet and sat in a corner. Observing this, Vagishtirtharu inquired, "Bhuvaraha." Then and there itself, he composed the Uga Bhoga in this way. Guru Bhakuti Beku, Hiriya Karuna Beku, Hari Kathegala Nitya Kelu Tira Beku, Virakuti Beku, Vishnupada Vina Radhane Beku, Varamantra Japa Beku, Tapa Beku Paragatige, Siri Hayavadanara Paramanu Graha Beku, Vishyani Graha Beku. These were the words composed by Vadiraja, by Bhuvaraha. This was the first Uga Bhoga composed by Bhuvaraha in his Purvashrama itself. Hearing this, Vagishtirtha Swamiji felt very happy and he immediately decided the next seer for the Vishnu Tirtha Math. When he expressed his desire to Bhuvaraha's parents, they were initially reluctant, but later they accepted when Vagishtirtha Swamiji blessed them with another child. Vagishtirtha crowned Bhuvaraha as the next pontiff to Vishnutirtha Math. After a few days, Vagishtirtha Swamiji entered Vrindavana. Vadiraja Tirtha Swamiji approached Sri Vyasarajaru in Hampi for further studies. Near Vyasarajaru, he completed his further scholarship, where he came across Purandaradasa, Kanakadasa, Vijayendra Tirtharu, King Krishnadevaraya, and all many other eminent personalities. He was even honored by King Krishnadevaraya and was given the title Prasangabharana Tirtha for his beautiful poetical skills. Later, Vadiraja Tirtha Swamiji returned back to Udupi. Sri Vyasarajaru gave him Vyasamushti as a blessing. There in Udupi, Vadirajaru had brought a major reform. The pontiffs of eight mathas used to perform puja to Lord Krishna as directed by Sri Madhvacharya. This was done with a rotation of 2 months for each math. But since 2 months was a very short period of time, problems arose in administration. Vadiraja created the Pariyaya system by changing the duration from 2 months to 2 years for each pontiff. Surprisingly, Vadirajaru completed 5 terms of Pariyaya at Udupi, and even today this Pariyaya system is being followed by all the Ashtamathas in Udupi. Once, during his visit to Tirupati, the entire hill, each and every stone of the hill was looking like a Shaligrama. Shaligrama is considered as a sacred stone, which is even considered as a deity. Hence, he could not put his legs on the sacred stone. He climbed the hill with his knees and hands itself. Such was the devotion of Vadiraja Tirtha Swamiji. Once, a goldsmith was making an idol of Ganapati. Even after many beads, it took the shape of Lord Hayagriva. The goldsmith that night got the dream to return the idol to Vadirajaru. The goldsmith did so, and Vadirajaru blessed the entire community of goldsmiths. Vadiraja Tirtha at the same time was teaching his disciples also. One of his disciples, Narayanacharya, was a brilliant student, but at the same time he was very much arrogant. He used to call scholars for debates, defeat them, and later make utter fun of them. One day, he even made fun of Vadiraja Tirtha itself. To teach him a lesson, the saint punished him to become a Brahma Rakshas. Even after becoming Brahma Rakshas, he didn't stop troubling people. He lived in the forest. He would take the form of a Brahmin and ask each and every passerby the question, Akamavai Kona Snataha. If the person didn't answer it, he would kill that person and eat him. Slowly he came to be known as Bhutarajaru, and soon no one passed that way. Once, Vadirajaru had to go to another town, and that was the nearest way from the middle of the forest. Everyone requested the sage, but Vadiraja took that way only. As usual, the demon asked Vadiraja. Vadiraja replied, Randa Putraha Tvam Na Snataha. What do we mean by Akamavai Kona Snataha? Akamavai. Ashada, Kartika, Magha, Vaishaka. These are the names of months according to Hindu calendar. What was the question? Who wouldn't take bath in the holy river during these months? Vadirajaru replied, one like you who has no eligibility to touch the holy waters wouldn't take bath. This was the conversation between Vadirajaru and Bhutarajaru. Later, Brahmarakshas debated with Vadirajaru and got defeated. He pleaded Swamiji and accepted to leave that place and promised not to trouble anyone since then. Even Vadirajaru also blessed Bhutarajaru and blessed him that at Sode, one would have to take darshan of Bhutarajaru first and then only have the darshan of Vadiraja Tirtha Swamiji. Even today, Bhutaraja Bali is given at Sode every day. Not just his miraculous sparse, his literary style is also amazing. He composed 2 extraordinary works, Rukminisha Vijaya and Lakshmi Shobhana. Lakshmi Shobhana, the woman of Madhva traditions, chant this daily. He composed over 1,000 suladis and innumerous dasara padagalu. He continued the tradition of dasa sahitya. He composed all of them under the signature Hayavadana. He even composed the commentaries like Tattva Prakashika Tippani, भगवद्गीता टिप्पणी तात्पर्य निर्णय टीका ही इवन कंपोज अबाउट मेनी स्तोत्रास लाइक कृष्णाष्टक एक्सेट्रा. श्री वादिराजरो लिव फॉर 120 लॉन्ग ईयर्स एंड परफॉर्म लॉर्ड कृष्णास पूजा इन उडुपी फॉर 5 पर्यायास. He entered the Vrindavana alive in Sode, Shirsi district. He is the first person whose Vrindavan is Sajiva Vrindavan. He crowned Shri Vedavyas Tirtha Swamiji as the next pontiff of Vishnu Tirthamat Parampara. He entered the Vrindavana alive on Falguna Bahula Tritiya in 1600. This day is celebrated as Shri Vadiraja Tirthas Aradhane. His Vrindavana is installed in Sode temple near Shirsi in Karnataka. Today on his Aradhana, let us all follow the path led by him. Let us at least chant few of the verses composed by him and follow the path led by him. Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.